I am joined with former Army Chief and General Bikram Singh. Sir, Qamar Javed Bajwa has been appointed as the Chief of Pakistan Army. Your first reaction to it?
Well, he served with me earlier. He was the brigade commander when I was the general officer commanding of the Eastern Division in Congo. And I would say that Pakistan Army is getting a professional to head it, to be at the helm of affairs. And what I saw of him at that point of time, which is good about 9 years ago, he was a very competent man, a great professional, very committed, very focused, very disciplined. And despite the animosity that we have here on our borders, I remember in the United Nations, his conduct was flawless, despite the fact that I was from India and he was from Pakistan. He was a totally a professional, I would say, a subordinate.
Sir, but given the nature, the volatility of the relationship between India and Pakistan, especially at the borders, how do you see this appointment? What does it mean for the India, sir?
Look, I do not foresee any changes as far as the overall strategy of Pakistan is concerned. There are a large number of compulsions, you see, on the Chief of the Army Staff. It's not that once he takes over, he can carry out a total change of the strategy or of the national policies. There are reasons as to why Pakistan will continue to behave the way it has behaved with us in the past, and that is basically that to attain, to keep that stature in their environment, in their society, they got to continue with the Kashmir issue. They got to have that animosity towards India being depicted everywhere on the line of control, otherwise also. And therefore, I do not see any change taking place, because that would be at the expense of their, I would say, a so-called coveted position that they have acquired in their own environment. So I don't find any change coming about, and I think it will just carry on the way things are.
Jain Singh, you just said that he was very professional when he was working under you in the UN, but you also said that we need to be very careful. What does that mean, sir?
Look, any professional person, you got to be careful about, because, you see, in the military, people do talk of, you know, strategic leaders having predictability. On the contrary, I feel strategic leaders have got to be unpredictable. And that's what I'm trying to say, that he's a professional guy. He knows the area totally along, you know, he's commanded 10 Corps, he's commanded FCNA, area opposite Siachen. He knows the entire area. And therefore, I think we got to be careful, even right from the strategic to tactical arena, as to how he conducts himself. But I suppose, knowing him at that point of time, 9 years ago, I feel his focus is going to be more, as he's brought out, I think, in one of the places, that he's going to be going hammer and tongs after the TPP and not perhaps be bothering much about India. But then, as far as the LC is concerned, I think the level of violence would continue at the line of control. I don't see this coming down. And this has been happening in the past, it will continue.
So also a major thing is that we have always seen differences between the relationship between the civilian government, the elected government of Pakistan, and then a military. So do you think this relationship will grow in a better pace, in a better way now?
No, I don't think so. You see, it's always happened. The Prime Minister will always choose, Prime Minister of Pakistan, will always choose a person whom he considers, you know, a bit pliable and who he thinks will perhaps be able to toe his line. But ultimately, as I said earlier, would Pakistan Army like to dilute its position in its environment is a big question mark. And I don't think the Army would be prepared to do that. It will continue to maintain that so-called, as I said, coveted stature in their environment, which they acquired, which to a large extent, I would say, entails stepping into the political domain, and which is actually not correct for any democracy. But that's how it has been in Pakistan, and I do not find any change coming about.